Should I buy a new computer to fix malware? No. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom for askleo.com with a very frustrating situation, and I know that a number of folks in my situation, technical professionals trying to help others, encounter this scenario fairly often. I want to be very, very clear about something. Malware does not physically harm your computer. Because of that, you do not need to buy a new computer if you're basically throwing up your hands when it comes to getting malware off your machine. I want to go through that a little bit because it's important to understand the concept behind this and the options you have if you ever find yourself even considering getting a new machine because of malware. One of the things that's really important to realize is that malware is just software. It's just another program on your machine. Software can be erased. Normally, we think about uninstalling or deleting a file. Malware, of course, makes efforts to make that really, really hard. Anti-malware tools will try to remove things for you, but the bottom line is that sometimes malware can be super persistent. Nonetheless, software can be erased. Malware is software. Therefore, malware can be erased. Now, like I said, they actually go out of their way to make erasing hard. That doesn't mean you can't do it. The scenario, the worst case scenario, is not getting a new machine. The worst case scenario is erasing everything on your existing machine, reformatting the hard disk, and then installing Windows from scratch, installing your applications from scratch, and restoring your data from backups. Erasing the entire hard disk at the beginning of that process erases everything, including any malware that's on the machine. Yep, it's painful. I get that. I really do. But if you're in a situation where you are frustrated and tearing your hair out because you believe that there's malware on your machine and you've been unable to get rid of it, this is what you do. You erase everything and start over from scratch. Let's face it. If you were to get a new machine, what would you have on it? A clean install of Windows, just like you just could have done by reformatting the hard disk and installing Windows from scratch. It's the same thing. It's the same result, except it's a lot cheaper. You don't need a new machine, and it can often be significantly faster than going through whatever it takes to actually get, install, and use a replacement machine. Erase everything. Now, one of the pushbacks that I often get when I talk about malware, erasing malware and so forth, is that the BIOS or UEFI on your machine is on your machine. It's called firmware. It is software that is stored in hardware. And yes, there are rare malware that can infect your BIOS or your UEFI. I want to stress that it is rare, and that if you think you have a BIOS or UEFI infection, you probably don't. However, even if you do, malware is just software that can be erased. BIOSes and UEFIs are just software that can be erased. There are various mechanisms, and it's going to depend on your specific computer and your specific BIOS, how you go about doing that. But all you really need to do at that point is contact the manufacturer of your machine for the instructions to reset and restore your BIOS. You don't need a new machine to do that. All you're really doing is replacing the software in the BIOS and, in that process, erasing the malware that's already there. Even if you're paying somebody else to do the work, because I understand reinstalling Windows from scratch is a significant piece of effort. Even if you're paying somebody else to do it, it's cheaper than getting a new machine. Like I said, even with a new machine, you're still now going to have to reinstall all your applications and restore your data from your backups. The bottom line here, the very, very important message, is that malware does not harm your computer physically, and you do not need to buy a new computer just to get rid of malware. If you're looking for an excuse to get a new machine, get a new machine. You don't have to do it because of malware. For updates, for comments, for links related to this article and more, visit askleo.com/12197. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.